prepares to reopen its high school, parents and school officials meeting as a beloved teacher is mourned. Students will return to the classroom tomorrow.
As a fellow student remains jailed on murder charges. Right now, our Julie Lonchek begins our live team coverage. She's in Danvers right now. Julie?
Ed and Heather, unimaginable to imagine school returning to normal tomorrow with candles still aglow tonight. But tomorrow, when they do return, counseling will accompany learning. More than 1,000 parents filed into Danvers High Thursday night. Colleen Ritzer's own words, a very real reminder of how much has been lost here.
My daughter's taking it very hard.
Ricky Howard came looking for answers. Explaining the unexplainable hasn't been easy.
Things will be back, you know. Not the way they were before, but it's going to take a period of time to get there.
Rob Prentice's daughter was in Miss Ritzer's home room and adored her.
And I told my kids that I'm not going to send you and your mom's not going to send you to a school that we don't think you're going to be safe in. And we're sending you to school tomorrow.
Officials are working through the night to make sure Friday is as normal as possible.
We'll never recover from the loss of Colleen, but we want to get this community and this school back to some sort of normalcy.
300 students, many with their parents, met with teachers and counselors ahead of the reopening. A full staff of counselors and child psychologists will be on hand tomorrow. And while much will remain the same, the bathroom where Colleen Ritzer allegedly lost her life at the hands of one of her students will be closed indefinitely.
This is an isolated incident that you can't ever predict. It just happened, and now we have to deal with it and deal with sort of the new reality that we live in here.
The police chief says they continuously monitor school safety. He says they will fully review this incident. Live in Danvers tonight, Julie Lonchek, WCVB News Center 5.